Hello everyone, welcome to our channel, that is Solid Master. This is our new tutorial in sheet metal, and this is our second video of sheet metal that you are seeing. This model is based on actually sheet metal, and this model name is electronic device casing. So I will tell you how to make this model in SolidWorks 2018 version, and some new commands will be there in sheet metal. I hope you seen this model. So let's go to make it. First of all, go to here sheet metal. If you don't have this sheet metal, then press here right click and select here sheet metal. If it is already there, then no need to select here. Right click and select here this tick mark. Okay. Now first of all select here base flange, and now select the top plane. Okay. Now go to here rectangle command. Select here center rectangle and select here center point. Make one rectangle here in our graphics area and select here smart dimension. Now apply here some dimensions like this. Make it 800 mm. Make sure that your units will be in mm. Click OK. Now go to again shard dimension, select this dimension and this one, make it 640 mm height. Okay. So our geometry is now fully defined. Now click here confirmation corner. Okay. So here they ask that how much the direction of thickness will be. So our thickness will be 1 mm as per our guidelines they have given here. In our description box you will see it, and K factor will be 0.5, relief will be rectangular. Keep as it is all these parameters and click OK. Okay. Now again we have to add here one sheet metal. So go to here edge flange. Select here this edge and click left click. So our next flange is created. So here bend radius will be 2 mm. Or make it 5 mm. Untick this use default radius and make it 5 mm. Now go here edit flange, so that we will edit our flange as per given drawing. Extend this line and go to here line command, select here this end point of line like this. Like this we have to close this and go to here smart dimension, make it 300 mm. And this total one will be we will again edit here. Select this point and this. Make it 375. Okay. And this height will be, delete this dimension here and make this height as 140 mm. Got it? And again we have to select this dimension. So select this line, make it 245 mm. Okay. So now our edge flange is closed, as you see here. Select here finish. So our flange is ready now. If you want to mirror, you can mirror it by using here features. Select here mirror. And what mirror you have to means mirror it. Select here in features to mirror edge flange and mirror about this right plane. Okay, so our flange is ready now. This is our preview of it. Click OK like this. Now again I will add some flanges here. So go to here sheet metal and again select edge flange. Select this one edge. Okay, and end condition will be 50 mm, like this. Again select one edge or here make a bend radius as 5 mm. As you see here, bend radius is what we are starting of our flange. From start to another flange, it will be bent at 5 mm radius and it should be in 90 degree. Okay, so again select this edge and change the direction of it like this. Delete this one and click OK. Again go to edge flange, select this one like this, 50 mm, make it dimension. Like this. Now in bottom also select here this edge or let it be. Okay, delete and click OK. But first of all, before clicking on OK, make it bend radius as 5 mm and then click OK. Now we have to create one hole here, we have to create one slot hole. So select this face and sketch it and select here straight slot. Right click and select. Now select here smart dimension, select this axis line and this and make it 140 mm. Now again select this arc, make it 28 mm radius. Now select this point and this point of slot, the distance will be 130 mm distance. Still also it is not fully defined, so select this point of arc to this edge and give it the dimension as 90 mm. Yes, now it is fully defined, and click here confirmation corner. Okay, now go to here extrude cut. We have an option in sheet metal here, extrude cut, select this one and select this sketch and go to here direction 1, select here through all, so that it will make a cut also in another sheet metal that we have created first, and click OK. So now our cut also has been done here. Now again we will add here some flanges. Here go to here edge flange, select here this edge, and select here this one also. If you select multiple edges, edge flange here, it will go on same direction, and here untick default radius and make 5 mm bend radius. Okay, like that way we have to create here this one. And this flange. Select here all the edges that we have to suppose to be a edge flange here. Okay. This arrow you can see here, we can also change here direction also like this. This one is a separate directions they have given, and this bar 6 are all same. Okay, now click OK in a green tick. Now we have to add here some lowers, like we have to add here punch operation in this surface. So I will go to here design library. As you can see here in my right side, right cursor, select here design library and go to here design library icon. Now go on forming tools, select here forming tool and select here lowers. As you can see here, we have created here lower. It is already been made here. Only just you have to drag and drop here, as you see in our previous video. Now select here position or flip the tool here from this side, so that it will go inward and outward like this, or you can change the rotation of this tool, make it 180 degree like this, so that it will be turned by using rotation angle, and go to position. Position means the dimension we will apply here some, so that it will be fully defined or it will be fixed. Go here smart dimension, select here this edge up to this point. Now make it 85 mm Select here this point. Select this edge. Make it 50 mm. Close the dialog box here. So our dimension has been given here. The main point of this tool is here. This is our origin point. So let it be keep as it is and click OK. Now you can see here our punching operation has been done. This is our punching operation. The name of this is a lower tool. Now we have to add here another lowers also. For this I will use here features and linear pattern. Select here this edge. And make it here 18. Not 18, make here intercess as 10 mm. But first of all we have not select here feature, so I will select here, go to underscroll option here and select here lowers. So this way they have done here, because we have select this vertical edge, that's why it is happening. So make it 3, intensis 3 and change the direction. Now make 50 mm distance like this and select their direction too. Select this edge. Make here 18. Pattern here seed only, that means it will only selected those features only. But we don't need this feature, so I will make here our normal pattern. So make the distance as 85 mm. No, it will be much longer. Make it 50. 50 also is much longer, so make it 20 mm. If you want to reduce the intensis, you can reduce here intensis on direction 2. Now it will be OK. And click OK. It will take some time to load here. See, it is being created here. Like this. Now on this face also we will create here, but for that I will use here mirror command. Select here symmetrical plane, like right plane I have selected because it is symmetric in component is in symmetric from right plane in equal distance 400 into 400. So select here lowers and linear pattern also and click OK. Left click OK. it has been done here. See, it is done. So now we have to create here vent. Vent option means it is a like ventilation we have to create here. So for that I will select here this face sketch, select here circle command, make one inner circle, bigger circle. Select here smart dimension, select this circle and give it 200 diameter. Again select here this edge to center point of circle, make it 200 mm distance. Select this edge to the center point, make it 160 mm distance. Okay. Now create here some circles here. Select this point, center point of circle. Okay, like this we have to create it. Now we have to create one center line. Again right click and go to sketch entities, select here line command. And select here smart dimension, select this center line up to this arc. Make it 5 degree angle. Okay. Now go to here circular sketch pattern. We will pattern this line. So for that select here entities to pattern, select this line and the point will be here this point. Make it 6 instances, okay, and close it. Now our vent drawing has been done here. So we have to make this here also, or we will first create this one vent. So these sketches will be underdefined, let it be. It should be connected to intersecting point, these lines. Now click OK, confirmation corner, and go to here sheet metal tool commands, select here this vent. It is used for airflow in both the plastic or sheet metal design, so that's why they have given vent for the ventilation of any component of any machine. So in vent parameters they have said that select the boundary. So I will select this boundary. It will automatically select this face. Now go to here ribs. The width of the ribs will be 8 mm. Okay, this is our width. Select here this lines. This is our ribs that we have created. One by one we have to select it. Now for spars, they have given the dimension. We will make here 4 mm. Or make it 8 mm or 4 mm as you wish. The depth will be 1 mm only. So select your spars. This circles that we have created, 2D geometry. Only this one we will remain as it is. Select your field boundary and select this arc. See, we have created our vent. Only we have to close this one. So click here, green tick, OK. So it has been done here. This is our vent. But actually we have created in wrong side, as you see. So we will make it again. So delete this one vent. I will make it again. Right click and edit sketch here. Select here the center line and use here mirror entities, mirror about this axis and entities to mirror. Okay. Now make it fully defined. Select smart dimension. Select this arc and make it 200. Okay. Select this arc.
make it 160.
Then select this dimension, make it 200. So here also I will select a center line. Select a smart dimension, select this arc up to this and make it 5 degree. Okay. So I will add here relations also. Add relation, select this point and this arc, make it coincident. Okay. And go to here conformation corner. Select here vent tool. Again select here boundary. So I will select here this boundary. For that depth will width will be 8 mm. Keep it 8 mm and depth will be 1 mm. So select here for ribs. So go to here sparse, for that make it 4 mm width. Select here this sparse. Select here fill in boundary, this one arc. Or make it 5 mm width. Click OK. Now it is been made properly here. So again we will use here mirror command. Go to features, select here mirror, vent already selected here. So we have to select here symmetric plane, right plane, and click OK. Okay, so our vent has been done here. Only we have to produce here holes on this surfaces. So select here this surface sketch and select here this circle command. Make first 2 circles. Okay. And select here center line. Select here center line. Select here center point. Now I will add here one relation. Select here add relation. Select this point and this center line. Make it coincident.
Select here add relation. Select this point and center line. Make it coincident. Now I will give here smart dimension. Make it 20 mm diameter. Select here add relation. Select this arc and this arc. Make it equal. Equal in radius. Now again select here mirror entities. Select here mirror entity. Select this arc. Mirror about vertical axis. Okay. Now go to here smart dimension. Select this point and this point of circle. Make it 535 mm. Okay, it has been made here. Now for this surface also we will make here circles. Select here circle, draw two circles. Okay. And distance will be from here to here 25. From this edge to this point, make it 50. Okay. And select here add relation. Select this arc and this one. Make it equal. Now for this circle also I will select here add relation. Select this arc and this arc. Make it equal. Okay. Again we have to apply here dimension. So select here smart dimension. Make it 50 mm. Select this arc to this point. Make it 25 mm. So for this surface I will choose here mirror entities again. Select the entities that we want here, these two circles, and mirror about vertical axis and click on OK. So our extrude cut the sketches has been made here. So go to confirmation corner and select here extrude cut. And give here OK. Or you might be change this linear pattern also. Go to here linear pattern. Edit this feature. Make it 50 mm or make it 35. And distance also make it 60, like this, and click OK.
It will take some time because we have created another mirror also, so that's why it will make here also in this our this portion, this one. Okay, as it is we will keep here. Now here also we will make here, add here holes. Select here sketch.
Select here center line. Right click and select here sketch entities, circle. Okay. Select your smart dimension. Make it 20 mm diameter. Select here add relation. Select this arc and this arc, make it equal. Select here mirror entities. Select this arc and mirror about. Mirror about this axis and click OK. Select here smart dimension and select this edge to this point. Make it 25 mm. Okay. Now for this also, go to here add relation. Select this point and this point and this one. Make it horizontal. Select your smart dimension. Select this point and this one. Make it 535. Okay. Close your confirmation corner. Or again we have to make here some sketches. One sketch is remaining. Select your circle. Now again I will select this edge. Make it 100 mm. Select here add relation. Select this arc and this arc. Select here smart dimension. Select this point and this arc. Select here mirror entities. Select this arc and mirror about vertical axis. Okay. Or make it 28 mm. Make it 30 mm. And click OK. Close it. Now again we have to make one hole here also. Select this face, this bottom face, and sketch it. So this is our last part that we are making here. Select here extrude cut. Now again select your smart dimension. Select this point and this arc. Make it 60 or make it 90 mm, so it will be look better. And select your smart dimension, select this arc, make it 20 mm diameter. Select this arc and up to this center point. Make it 35 mm diameter. Okay. Select your center line right click select your mirror entities select this arc and mirror about this axis that we have drawn and click OK. Go to here conformation corner. Now go to here extrude cut, select here these faces that we have created, go to here contours, one by one we will select here contours, this is not selecting, so I will make another cut here, make it a 10 mm line and click OK. Done. So go to here extrude cut, select here this arc. Select here this also and naked click OK. So our model is completed, only we will render this model. Okay, so I will select here material for our model. Go to here material, right click on it and select here ABPS, or I will select here this one nickel. Go to here material and select here edit material option. Apply here this glass one or whatever material you can select here, you can select it by yourself. Okay, so I will select here this one. Close it. Now I will apply here background also. Go to here edit, apply scene and select here rooftop. So this is our rendering and this is our model that we have made. I hope you like it. So please subscribe our channel for more interesting projects in SolidWorks, Creo, AutoCAD. Friends, thank you for watching it. Take care.